really wants to know why Ravan is portrayed in a negative light when he is a Tamilian himself, and he says Ravan was a Tamil, great Tamilian king and a big devotee of Shiva. So of course everybody portrays him in a negative light, but he was really a powerful and respected person in his time as well.
Yes, in fact, look, if you look at the story, I hope I don't rattle you too much. I've got a habit of rattling the Hindu, traditional Hindus, but I like to say something. Somebody told me, Mr. Lakhani, look, why are you blaming poor Ravan for abducting Sita? Ravan's sister had fallen in love with Ram, and she tried to make advances toward Ram in the forest, and Ram, instead of saying, shoo, go away, I'm already married and leave me alone, Ram sent the poor girl to Lakshman, and Lakshman got really mad at her. And what did they do? Just because she was making advances, she loved the youngsters, Ram and Lakshman, so she was making advances, understandable human thing. And instead of saying, go away, we don't want your advances, they actually chopped off her nose. Now look, if you did that in the modern world today, you will have everybody after you. So of course, Ravan was furious. And he said, let me, you know, in a way, take retribution and, you know, abduct Sita. This is the story. So why are you blaming poor Ravan? He was just really upset. I would be upset as well if somebody chopped off my sister's nose. And he was just taking revenge. So when you look at this story, there's another aspect. Look, I'm lightening up. But the thing is this. Always when we try and do storytelling, we like to polarize. The good is real good, clean cut. You know, there's no blemish whatsoever. So Ram is clean cut and good. And Ravan, you have to depict him in a negative role, because otherwise you can't have a story. If you want a story, you must have good and evil, and fight between good and evil. So what you have done is, over thousands of years, this Ramayana story, we have really polarized Ravan into this very negative condition, negative situation. He was a great devotee of Shiva and a very, you know, very powerful personality. In fact, one of the things that comes out of the story of Ramayana is interesting. It shows that they did actually recognize the power of Ravan. When Ravana had been, you know, shot by Ram, Ram said, Lakshman, this is not an ordinary man. He's a great pandit, a great vidwan. He's a very intellectual person. If you want to learn how to run a kingdom, go and stand next to him, ask him to teach you. He's the best teacher regarding, the best person you can learn from. He's a great pandit. And Lakshman went to sat with Ravana to learn about this secret of how to rule a big kingdom. So they did actually acknowledge that Ravan is not all bad, really. There are a lot of good parts to Ravan. But at the same time, look, in storytelling, this thing happened. It's not because I have any, you know, or the Hindus have any animosity toward the Tamil community or the Shiva devotees. It's simply when the story gets told and retold, this polarization becomes even more. That's why you can't find a single blemish on Ram, except they said, oh, why did he, you know, kill Vali for hiding behind a tree? So they find one or two things. Why did he ask Sita to go walk through fire? But overall, they generally show him in a very glossy light, and poor Ravan gets hit. So please recognize storytelling. Even though they have historic foundation, we have wound up the story. Recognize that, and then you feel comfortable.